the Chem Activity 6 and the corresponding sets of videos, we will explore how the technique of mass spectrometry can be used to determine the molecular mass and to some degree some structural features of a molecule. Mass spectrometry is an analytical technique that is especially important in organic chemistry as it allows for the determination of molecular mass and molecular structure and the identification of unknown compounds and even quantification of the amount of compound in a sample. This technique can even be applied to the study of large macromolecules such as proteins. But our focus will be on relatively simple molecules in this chem activity. This diagram outlines the basic functioning of a mass spectrometer. The applied sample must be first vaporized. That is, all the molecules must be in the gaseous phase. The sample is then bombarded by an electron gun that projects a stream of high-energy electrons. The goal is to knock out a single electron from each molecule, thereby ionizing them to a radical cation. A radical, in this context, is a molecular particle with an odd number of electrons. The power of the electron gun is set so that the majority of the molecular ions will have a +1 charge. As we will discuss, given the high-energy environment, further fragmentation usually occurs, and any residual cations are then accelerated down a tunnel by an electric field. A vacuum is applied to the tunnel so as to minimize interference from other gaseous molecules, such as molecular nitrogen and oxygen, in the air. Note that the tunnel is curved, so that if nothing else happens, the cations would simply strike the curved wall of the tunnel. But what does happen, however, is a variable magnetic field is applied, which can deflect the cations towards the detector. The strength of the magnetic field required to deflect a cation is correlated with the mass of the cation. The bigger the ion, the greater the magnetic field required. The magnetic field strength is calibrated with carbon-12 isotope as a standard. The bigger the ion, the greater the magnetic field required. The magnetic field strength is calibrated with carbon-12 isotope as a standard. A spectrum of relative abundance in the y-axis versus the mass-to-charge ratio, m over z, in the x-axis is generated. Because the charge of the cations have been set to +1, the x-axis effectively represents the mass in atomic mass units. This simulation provides a summary and a visual representation of the working of a mass spectrometer. We start with a vaporized sample in the ionization chamber. In this example, we have a mixture of different molecules, as we can think of each colored dot corresponding to a molecule of a different mass. Here we see a high-energy electron knock out an electron from the molecule, forming the molecular cation. This simulation does not show further fragmentation, but because we have molecular ions of different mass, we can see how they behave in the tunnel. Currently, the magnetic field is set so that the blue particles are deflected just sufficiently to be measured by the detector. Note, the green and red particles simply collide with the walls of the tunnel. The magnetic field strength is increased, and now the green particles are detected. Finally, the highest setting of the magnetic field allows for the heavier red particles to be detected. It is worth mentioning that normally we'll be looking at mass spectra that come from analyzing only one type of molecule. The different peaks will come from the fragmentation patterns of that molecule. Let us now return to the chem activity notes and highlight some important definitions. Molecular ion, which is symbolized as brackets M plus, this is a radical cation formed by the removal of a single electron from a parent molecule in a mass spectrometer. This is also called the parent ion. A few points here. Recall that radical, as in radical cation, signifies an odd number of electrons in the cation. Without realizing it, perhaps, thus far in chemistry courses, you've only been dealing with molecules that have an even number of electrons. Another point is to keep in mind that the mass spectrometer will detect different isotopes. Therefore, typically we associate the molecular ion with the molecule where all the carbon atoms correspond to isotope carbon-12. We will look later how the carbon-13 peak will give us additional information. And again, also keep in mind that the molecular ion is known as the parent ion, base peak. This is the tallest peak in the spectrum, which is assigned a relative value of 100%. This peak corresponds to the cation that is present in the largest amount. Given that the molecular ion undergoes further fragmentation, it is rare that the molecular ion gives rise to the base peak. In fact, in many mass spectra, the base peak is barely detectable. Keep in mind that in any analysis, we're dealing with a huge number of particles, over 10 to the 20. Some of these will remain intact and will be detected as the molecular ion, whereas others will fragment into smaller portions of the molecule. Those portions which are more stable are generally more abundant, and they will be seen as larger peaks in the spectrum. While I mention all of this here, some of it may not yet make sense to you. You may wish to come back to these definitions and discussions after you've seen some of the examples to follow.